Ladies and gentlemen, making his way into the red corner, from Derby, representing the Derby Alliance, Danny
Tyler now making into his way into the ring for the sixth bout on tonight's BCFC 5 card. I'm here with Ian the Machine Freeman. Danny Tyler, unfortunately, was one of the ones that I didn't get to speak to prior to the bout. However, he does come from Alliance Derby BJJ, and we've seen their fighters before. They have an excellent work ethic. They look to pressure into the clinch, work for the takedown, and control from top position. I've been very impressed with their fighters prior to this fight, so I'm hoping that we have exactly the same quality here tonight. Now Clayton is based at Enigma MMA. This is Enigma MMA's debut, as well as Clayton's. He's a BJJ and Muay Thai fighter. He's got about 3 years training behind him, and he is a half guard specialist. He looked very much for the attack. I don't think he'll be a stalling fighter at all. And his main trainer has been Paul Rice, who is, of course, Gracie Barha. He feels good, he feels confident. He's happy keeping it standing. On the count of his Muay Thai background, he wants to put on a show.
Well, he's got the big man himself, the heavyweight Carl Etherington, in his corner as well. As we know, Carl Etherington, he's gone to Bellator, he's got a four-fight contract. Never been beat in his MMA career. Awesome fighter. Beautiful boxer, really.
And a big
strong
promotion, big promotion.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a welterweight contest. Three-minute rounds in a welterweight division between, and introducing to you firstly, fighting out of the red corner, coming to you by way of the Derby Alliance, Danny Tyler.
The crowd seems to be warming up for this fight. Both fighters have a lot of support.
Across the cage, his opponent. He comes to you by way of Enigma MMA from Blackpool, Hector.
Well, here we go, Danny Tyler versus Clayton Morris. Tyler from the Jiu-Jitsu background, will he want this on the floor? Throwing a nice high kick first to start off. Now on the tie clinch. He had the body lock, looking for the throw, missed it.
This is what the Alliance fighters specialise in. They put their opponents up against the cage, they work for the takedown, and they rough them up in the process.
Well, as you see there, Morris has got the overhook there. It's stopping Tyler from going down. Now
he's
left it.
He's using his well. He's got a nice plumb and a lovely knee there.
Oh, nice knee to the head. But big shots coming back from Tyler.
He's gone down for the double. It was a nice defence. He's using that plumb very well on top.
Very, very strong. Nice knees.
Oh, sweet.
Caught a knee on the way down. Nice sprawl.
Strong sprawl.
Works his underhooks.
That's a nice control he's got on there.
Working for the guillotine.
Mounted. Is he mounted? No, we're in half. Top half. He's not quite going for it,
I
don't think.
I was
think.
Just going to say, it's not underneath the chin. But now in the guard of Tyler. It's in the half guard.
I'd like to think that Clayton is comfortable here. Being a half guard specialist himself, he's going to know how to pass that. The question is whether he's going to want to.
Whether he wants to. Now in the full guard. Well, you think Tyler, being a BJJ guy, should be comfortable here, should know submissions from here, sweeps from here.
Clayton's doing very well because he's nullifying his hips, pushing him up against the cage. As long as he keeps those hips down, he's going to struggle to sweep him.
The guard's wide open, he could pass at any time. Got another guillotine,
yeah,
Tyler.
Watch that. That's it.
Tyler back to his feet. Lovely.
Very well there.
Again.
Going in from both fighters here. They're really working the body.
Nice sprawl there by Clayton Morris.
Sprawl. Gonna work for the O. He's gonna work for the
armbar.
Oh, he
took the back.
Oh, lovely. Pins the arm down with his right leg. He's gonna go for the RNC. He's got a double hand defence there, on that arm around his neck. Doing exactly right. He slipped it over his mouth.
Oh, 10 seconds. Well, the end of the round was in favour of Danny Tyler. Caught in the rear naked. Clayton Morris just didn't have enough time to finish it.
I'm hoping for another two rounds of that. I love that sort of action.
It was sweet, wasn't it? It was nice. Nice, clear action. But I'll tell you what, the clinch work, the tight clinch in the knees from Morris is working beautiful.
Yeah, they were very nice.
And how sweet was he sprawling every time that Tyler jumped.
He was going
leg.
Straight away, yeah. Those relentless hits to the body and taking some nasty sprawls. It's tiring work, that, isn't it?
Oh, it does. It wears you out. I tell my students, you know, that the clear shots that you give your opponent, the quicker they will tire. It's wasted shots that are no good, but if you get clear shots to the body or to the head, your opponent will tire quicker than if you didn't throw them shots. Here we go, second round. Oh.
Nice right hand. Again, straight to clinch.
One under, one over body lock. See, Morris, he was using the head to control his opponent, but Tyler does well.
Nice.
Reversing with a big knee.
Lovely.
Both guys working these beautiful in this fight.
Those body shots really must be taking their toll on both fighters. And he's gone tight. Look at that.
Oh, there's a guillotine.
Nice.
But well done by
Tyler.
Side control.
The side.
Turns out that guillotine easy, going for the armbar.
He looks comfortable though, Clayton. Is he going to be able to get this out? Oh, nicely done. Nicely done. He stopped those legs working.
Equally matched this bout.
Yeah, very much so. Good matchup. He doesn't want to move around too much because he's got that grip on his arm and he knows that it could become an overplaster or Kimura, so he's slowly but surely waiting for the opportunity for him to pass properly, I think. Yeah, see that leg that's in under the shoulder? He's going to turn him with it now. Nicely done again. He's going to have to be careful.
Wallace used the cage to push off, but an awkward position he's in. He's holding onto his arm for dear life. That's the thing, if he does leave go of that, he could get caught in an old bladder.
That is not a nice position for him to be in now. That is not nice at all. I think he's doing very well to defend it, to be honest. He's going to look to take some punishment in his ribs as well. If he can, he needs to step his right leg over his head, and I know that the cage is stopping him.
What seemed to be nearly a one-sided round for Morris in the first round,
it's quickly switched.
It switched over.
Oh, nice, he's out. Lovely. He did well, he was very patient to sit that out, Bates, and did well with that.
This is beautiful work by Tyler.
Lovely back transition.
He missed it. Morris needs to be careful, turn his back again.
He's staying very tight with his arms, but I think that right arm's gone under his chin, is it?
It's hard to see from all positions. No, Morris defends it. Wow, again, what a fantastic round.
Yeah, I think we're looking at one each. That's a solid one each.
So who will want it more in this third round? Well, like I say, the first round, it just seemed to be all Morris. Although the Tyler was doing well to defend, Morris seemed to take control. And then in the second round, it seemed to switch. Tyler took control, and Morris was defending for most of that round.
The conditioning of these guys seems to be very good. You'd hope so in Morris's case, because it's pole places are very high importance on strength and conditioning. But looking at that, Tyler 2 looks fairly fresh.
Oh, big left hand, Zach. Oh!
He's walking through them. He wanted that clinch then.
Took a little bit of punishment on the way in, but he got it. Tyler jumping for guillotine, doesn't get it.
It'd be interesting to see what a difference the A rules would make in this sort of bout, Ian, I think.
Yeah, when there's ground and pound involved. And again, he jumps for the guillotine, he's got it, it's an arm in guillotine. But can Morris defend it?
He's got his shoulder right in there, he is doing his very best. You've got to wonder about the strength in Tyler's arms. Can he hack that now?
Especially in the third round.
Absolutely.
He's got to be tired.
Yeah, look at that pressure he's putting through with his hips now. Trying to take that guillotine off.
Yeah, he's going up high, stacking them as they call it. Stacking back.
Yeah.
Tyler decides to leave it.
Going for that Kimura.
Well, both guys have got to work hard, because it's equal right now. It's one round apiece. But saying that, we're not the judges. We're just
absolutely
commentating. Sometimes we can, miss a few things what the judges see.
I don't want Morris to sit here. You know, if he wants to take this bout, he's got to go for the pass.
Yeah, go for it.
Yeah.
Go for it. Triangle attempt.
He's very active off his back, Tyler. He's doing an excellent job of being a complete annoyance to Morris.
And that's what the judges will see. They'll see him trying things. They'll see him attempting things. He's tried the guillotine, tried the triangle.
We're just seeing those gaps above his knees with his arms. They need to be tight into his thighs from top position, because Tyler will take the opportunity to hip bump and go for the Kimura and hip escape, which is exactly what he's doing now.
Trying for the sweep is Tyler. Again, guillotine attempt. Decides not to lock it up. I just think that Morris needs to do a little bit more because the body shot is not going to win him the round. Again, triangle attempt. Submission after submission attempt from Tyler. Do you think Morris is just a little bit tired?
I think so, yeah. I think he's happy to wait there in that top position. And Tyler is very active off his back. He's got a lot of control over his posture. And he's probably going to try and sweep again before the end of the round.
And time, third round. Well, it looks if the first round was Morris and the last two was Tyler. But it's down to the judges. Let's see what they see.
Whichever way this decision goes, I think that Clayton Morris has done a good job today. I mean, that is the first debut for his gym. It's the debut for him. He certainly put on a good show.
Oh, without a doubt. I mean, to be honest, he could still have it. We need to listen to the judges' scorecards. But whichever way it goes, he should be proud of himself. He did really well out there.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the scorecards. Your winner by unanimous decision, Danny Tyler!
Yeah, I thought Danny Tyler just got it there. Unanimous by all judges, they must have given the two rounds to the one that we thought of.
I think that was probably one of the best bouts we've had so far.
Really enjoyed that. Definitely technical, definitely skillful, enjoyed it.